Well, Aussies are jumping on the couch for the cheap seats, the comedy show that takes an hilarious look and deep dive into the weekly news cycle. That was funny, Tash. Sorry. And sometimes the host's own antics feature on Studio 10. Maybe this will too.
Nominations were announced up on the Gold Coast, Mel, and we've actually found some footage of you at the ceremony.
It's the 2022 TV Week Logie Awards nominations announcement and the stars are here.
What are you doing in the background of Studio 10?
It was kind of humiliating because Angela Bishop came up to me and she was like, hey, can you be on in this shot? Mm. And I was like, oh, great. And she was like, in the background, please. Not even to be upgraded to the foreground of Studio 10.
Well, you're not on the foreground of Studio 10. That's when you know things aren't going well.
Hey, host Melanie Bracewell joins us now live from Melbourne. How are you? Congratulations, darling.
I can't believe it. I've made it to the foreground of Studio 10. This is huge for me.
I tell you what, you know how to work a red carpet, girlfriend. Mm-hmm. Was that like some serious twerking going on there?
Yeah, well, I thought, you know, if you want me to be in the background of the shot, I can't not pull focus. So I had to show off my S-drops, as they call them.
Pull focus you did. Hey, tell us, what was it like to get the call and to be told the news that you're being nominated for a Logie?
Oh, I was so excited. I was even excited when they sent me an email saying that you were invited to the Logies. I've never responded to an email faster in my life. Tim, my co-host, sent me a message going, you don't respond to production emails that quickly. So I was just honoured to
even
be invited.
Will this be your first Logies?
Yeah, first one, for sure. Yeah, the Logies is something that I have been aware of, even being a New Zealander, so it feels quite cool. Oh.
So, Mel, it's Ange here. On the red carpet on Sunday night, I reckon I'm perfectly happy to swab it. I'll be in the background. You do the stuff in the front and I'll do some of the dropping. What do you reckon?
Oh, yes, I would love to see you shake it.
really, no, that would not be for the best. Hey, listen, your sports bet, see what a gambler I am, sports bets pick to win. So, has that made you... Have you put pen to paper? Have you written a speech?
It is... I know. I was quite shocked to see that, but I didn't realise that algorithm is based on how many people are betting, and it's probably thrown off by the fact that I've put my entire life savings into it. you know, if I don't win, it will be financial ruin.
Right, pressure.
Mel, Tash here. How are you, potty mouth little petal of perfection, darling?
Hello. Oh, that's so cute.
Always good. I'm waiting for your cheap shot now, but... anyway, today it's my show, so I'll have it coming for you. Darling, The Cheap Seats is also up for a Logie itself, a most popular comedy, and so it should be because I've been on it 3 times. But it's also up against Have You Been Paying Attention in the same category. Is the competition heating up between the two shows? And do you like me?
First off, Needy. No, but no, no, I love you, Tash. You're awesome. You were such a highlight on our show. Us being against Have You Been Paying Attention, we work in the same building, so we have to sort of set any, you know, rivalries aside. Although I have noticed that the Have You Been Paying Attention, their past Logies, I feel like they've moved them to be more prominent in the office. I didn't notice them before, but now every time I walk to the kitchen, it feels like
they're
right in my face. Yeah.
That's what they're doing. They're psyching you out. Is there anyone you're hoping to bump into at the Logies? Any big stars? Anyone you might get a bit fangirly over?
Just you guys, 100%. I don't know. It's weird because even though I grew up in New Zealand, I, after school, was watching Home and Away every day. So it's like all these Australian shows are playing in New Zealand all the time because we don't have much telly. So there's quite a few people I'm excited to see. When I saw Al from Home and Away, I got quite starstruck.
And why wouldn't you? I do have to forewarn you, Mel, that if you do win, you will thereafter be an Australian because we claim anyone who wins awards here.
This won't get shown in New Zealand, right?
No, exactly.
Okay, good. I'll take it.
You'll be like a funny Russell Crowe to us.
And a beautiful one.
And a beautiful one, of course. Vote for Mel for Outstanding Newcomer and also for The Cheap Seats for the most popular comedy program. definitely stick it up the guys that haven't been paying attention. You can head to TVWeekLogiesVote.com. Plus, tune into the cheap seats, of course.
Yes! Nice. Tuesday nights at 8:40 on 10 and 10 play on demand.
We love you, Melanie Bracewell, you hot little thing.
Okay, great.
Have fun. Bye.